Now, looking down the road, there is an issue critical not only for Oakland County, but for the entire state of Michigan, and that's the 2010 census. The population count determined by this census will be used to apportion U.S. House of Representatives seats, and it also doles out, based on the census, $300 billion in federal programs. Now, we're going to lose one seat from our congressional delegation this year. We don't want to lose two. We saw the effect of our waning influence in Washington during the congressional hearings on the auto crisis. What that underscored was the need to retain as many seats and influence as we can in Congress. We also want to ensure we get our full proportionate share of federal dollars back to Michigan. Right now, it is estimated that Michigan gets $1,000 every year in federal money for every person counted. So that's why it's critical to be counted and make sure we include the snowbirds. If you are in sunnier climes when you receive the census form, I'm encouraging you to wait until you return to Michigan before filling it out so that you are accurately counted back here. It is estimated that back in the 2000 census that there were 200,000 Michigan residents that were counted in other states because they filled out the census while they were out of state. Now, over the decade, do the math. That represents a loss of $2 billion in federal services and revenue sharing. Now, I don't want that to happen again this year. So please spread the word to anyone you know to fill out the census form here, fill it out in Michigan, and if you spend 6 months and a day living here. I definitely want to acknowledge tonight, before I close, the nationally recognized award-winning IT department. They are so integral to everything we do, led by Deputy County Executive Chief Information Officer Phil Berlini and the IT Director Ed Poisson. IT is basking in some well-deserved national recognition that I just mentioned ago. Besides that great award from the Center for Digital Government, IT has accomplished so much more. They are developing systems and software that will help cut the cost of county government. For instance, they are virtualizing our servers. That means instead of having lots of hardware to store the county's 25,000 pages of web content and other data, they are storing it now in 80 virtual servers. This saves on electricity, it saves on the cost of maintaining of expensive computer equipment. Over time, IT will save the county millions of dollars when the use of the virtual server is fully implemented. IT is helping the health division save money on food inspections and well and septic inspections. They have developed software that streamlines the inspection process. Inspectors can enter their reports now on laptops from their car. They don't have to come back to Pontiac to file them. The inspectors stay in the field longer. They complete more inspections and save fuel on the county vehicles. This program is so successful, believe it or not, we've rolled it out for the state of Michigan and other counties, so they too may save costs with their inspections. IT is making Oakland County government more accessible and user-friendly to our residents. They made it easy for residents to pre-register online with the health division to receive their H1N1 vaccinations. Now, it's unpleasant to get a traffic ticket, we know that, but IT has made it easy to pay that ticket online. For those who have been pulled over by a police officer, you will note that today they print the ticket in the car and then hand it to you. Now, you can thank Oakland County's IT department for the development of the software called e-citation. Come on, stand up, Phil, ahead. Last year, IT launched a new county executive site, oaklandgov.com/exec. This year, they're moving me into the world of social networking. Now I'm a guy who needs my grandkids to program my remote. So this social networking is a little bit new to me. But it's part of a bigger plan to communicate more effectively with Oakland County residents, businesses, and the media. The executive office has a Facebook site, which we are using to communicate vital information to the public, such as H1N1 vaccination clinics or business development workshops. I don't know if you've seen my picture on Facebook, but it depicts an old geezer in a discernibly churchy state, unwilling or incapable of smiling. That's what you see. The executive office is on Twitter. In fact, IT is tweeting key messages from tonight's state of the county as we speak. Hope they don't tell that story about Greg Meyer. Now, what is Twitter? Well, Mike Zinder thinks it's merely a way for students to pass answers back and forth during chemistry test. It's more than that. It's a very important communication tool. It proved its value during the aftermath of last year's election in Iran, when the Islamic clerics who control the government there clamped down on media coverage about the street demonstration. Information was still getting out, but only by Twitter. IT has also launched me onto YouTube. If I have an important message to communicate via video, we want to reach beyond our own website. We want to make sure the message is available to as many who need to see it. In fact, excerpts of the state of the county address will be posted on YouTube tonight. So if you like what you hear tonight, you can rush right home and see it all over again. Yeah. Finally, in the coming year, my IT department will be working on Web 2.0 technologies. It's state-of-the-art stuff. It'll be a way for residents to interact with government like they never have before. Before I close tonight, there's a gentleman in the audience I wish to acknowledge. He was a part of my administration on day one back in January of 1993. He recently chose to retire and lead the good life. He was my first media and communication officer who did yeoman service for not just my department, but for many other departments in county government who, I'm sure like me, will miss his professionalism and his good sense of humor. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me recognize a good friend, the retired Bob Dustman. Bob, where are you? Hey, Bob. Tonight I had two options. I could have dwelled on the challenges of our economy, but we all know those challenges too well. Or I could leave you with a positive message that we have a great team here in Oakland County, including my staff, but also the other countywide elected officials with whom I am privileged to serve. Our legislative body, the Oakland County Board of Commissioners, and our outstanding courts and judges, they are all managing through these tough budget years in a manner which I hope makes you proud. As I say every year at this point in the speech, thank you. Thank you so much for letting me serve you as Oakland County Executive. It's a privilege and it's a pleasure and it's a job of a lifetime. And may this year be a good year for all of you and Oakland County. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. For the most important announcement tonight, when those doors open, the reception is right across the hall. Thank you.